either. Even today, lot of data is imported from CSV files. Many things can go wrong, but the most dangerous one I would say is dates going wrong. So let's look at an example, understand the problem and solve it. If you don't have time to go through all this, look at the link above and look at the 1 minute short. This is the CSV I've got. It's simple, one column, it just has dates. Now the question is, and you can tell me, is it DDMMYY or MMDDYY? The only way to answer that is to find some number which is above 12. And that must be the day. So this is MMDDYY. Now the problem is most people double click on a CSV and it automatically opens in Excel. Now generally what happens, there will be some hash because it's not fitting in. Most of the people in the world will double click here and then apparently it fits and no problem. Actually, huge problem. When you are dealing with any date column, you should never have just enough width, you should have extra width, and then you will know the problems. The idea being, dates are stored as numbers, you know that, and numbers are right aligned, text is left aligned. So here now we can see that some dates are understood apparently, those are right aligned, and those which are not understood as dates are left aligned, they remain text. Now the question is, are these dates correct or are these dates correct? If you look at this data, you can see very clearly that this is MMDDYY. So this is 1st Jan, this is 1st March, this is 1st April, this is 1st May and so on. And the last one is 1st of December. Now let's go back to what we just did and let's apply DDMMMYY formatting. Control 1 is the shortcut. Or you can say right click and format cells or control 1 DDMMMYY. And notice the problem. All of them are 1st Jan, 2nd Jan, 12th Jan. So this is wrong. Excel has understood it wrongly. It is going to calculate it wrongly. And this is a problem. Now, of course, these dates are not even understood by Excel. So obviously this part is also wrong. But there is a good thing. Because as a human, when you read this date, you know it is 13th of Jan. Even if Excel has not understood these as dates, human beings understand these. Whereas here, human beings are actually understanding the wrong date where the month and day has been swapped. That is going to lead to wrong calculations, wrong decisions, and negative business impact. Here, the data is coming in MMDDYY format. And if you go to my settings, the regional settings are DDMMYY. So when you double click on a CSV, Excel is just going to blindly import each column using this format which is set in Windows. So it's importing MMDDYY as DDMMYY, and that's why all those problems happened. The only way to control that is not to double click on the CSV. You have to rename it as TXT. You're not changing the content at all. You're just changing the extension. Why is that? Because by default, CSV extension is mapped to Excel, so it opens it. Whereas TXT extension is not mapped to Excel, so it does not open it. Now, how do you open it in Excel? Well, you'll have to go to File, Open, and then open it. So let's do that. Now, when I go to the same folder in File Open dialog in Excel, you will not be able to see any file because by default, it's looking for Excel files. So you go to All Files, then you will see the TXT. Open it. Excel understands that this file has data and it needs more information about what to import, how to import, and so on. So it shows the text import wizard. This is the same as text to columns. So now we go to the next step. There are no delimiters right now because we have only one column. Go to the next step, and this is important. Right now we have one column, so it's already selected. But if there were multiple columns containing dates, we'll have to do it one by one. You select the column. Notice general means basically Excel will do whatever the default formatting setting tells it to do. We don't want that. We want to tell Excel treat this as date and it should be MDY format because we can see it. The question is, can you see it? Because we have seen the data earlier, you know this is MMDDYY. If you are opening it directly here, you have no idea. So here you have to scroll down till you come across something which is above 12. And now you know for sure it is MMDDYY. Now you can click on finish and now everything is hash because of width problem. But now I'm going to increase the width and we will apply the DDMMMYY format. The shortcut is Shift Control 3. And now you'll realize everything is perfect. Now this is one way of doing it. If you have been following my recommendations, the only and the correct way of importing any kind of data and cleaning any kind of data in Excel. So here is a blank Excel file. We'll go to data, get data from file CSV. It's also there directly. And then choose the CSV file. The navigator dialog will tell you what to do with it. Do you want to load it as it is or transform data? You never say load because it's always going to land you into trouble. Even if you are very sure, there's no harm in going to transform and checking everything is okay, especially data types for each column. So now it shows the data as it is. Now what we are going to do is change this. This is ABC, means it is text. Now if you try to make it date, exactly the same problem will occur. Because we are not sure what will happen, it's better to add a new step. So now another change type, and notice exactly the same problem occurred because the setting is still DDMMYY. So this is not going to work. In Power Query, if you want to do something which went wrong, remove it, undo, just click on this cross. Okay, so what do? We have to go to this option, which is not very intuitive, but that's all we have. Here you choose the data type as date. And then instead of directly typing MMDDYY, you choose a country in which country there is MMDDYY as the default. That's why it's called locale. Locale means location or country to be specific. So now in this case, I've chosen English US and now everything will work fine. And then we go and say home. Small little data you can always use as table. So click OK. And now we have data in correct format. Just to prove that it is correct, we'll apply DDMMMYY formatting. I've shown you two methods of doing this. Potentially there can be many other methods, but I would say the Power Query method is the best because when more data is added in the text file, you can just say refresh and get the data automatically cleaned. Any other method is going to require you to drag formulas and stuff like that. So that is how you solve CSV date import problems. If you found this useful, please share it with as many people as you can, especially those who are struggling with data every day. I create a lot of content like this on a very regular basis. So if you want to learn more, subscribe and click on the bell icon. Put your thoughts, put your queries or your ideas about what content I should create in future in the comments column. I read every comment very sincerely and respond to it very, very quickly. So that's it for now. Thank you.